Hello friends, nowadays we are doing East Standard 10 Maths, chapter number 7, coordinate geometry, and this is my 6th lecture in this chapter. In the previous lecture, we have completed exercise number 7.1. Now we go for further information in the chapter. Today we are going to learn section formula. What is section? To make part. If a point makes two parts of a line segment, not necessarily they are equal parts, they are of the different length, then the point which divides the line segment into the given two parts, if I take the ratio of one part upon second part, it forms the ratio of the parts. Okay, so if I want to know what are the coordinates of the point which divides the line segment into the given ratio, that formula is known as section formula. Before that, we take one introductory example and we study. In the previous lecture, we have one example. If you remember, one town is A, we took it as origin, and one town is S point B, it is having the coordinate 36 and 15. Do you remember? Two towns. And we found out the distance between these two towns using the distance formula. But today, suppose the government authorities wants to establish one dispensary or the hospital on the line joining these two towns, and the location of point P where the hospital is going to be located, suppose these are x, y, these are the coordinates. It is saying that distance of town B from that hospital is two times the distance of that hospital from town A. So it is PB is two times PA. PB is two times PA. If I take ratio PA upon PB, it will be equal to 1 upon 2. So ratio PA is to PB is 1 is to 2. 1 is to 2 is the ratio. Okay. Now, how to find out the coordinates of this point P, x and y, that I discuss with you. From point P, let the perpendicular be drawn intersecting x-axis at point C. Naturally, it is a right angle triangle. From point B, let it come down the perpendicular intersecting x-axis at point D. It is also a right angle triangle. From point P, I draw a line parallel to x-axis which intersects line segment BD in point E. So this angle BEP is also a right angle triangle. Okay. Now, in chapter 6 that you are supposed to study afterwards, in that there is one theorem for two triangles to be similar. At present, you will understand what is similar triangles, but just I tell you one topic of similar triangles, that if in two triangles, any kind of triangles, not compulsorily right angle triangle, but here in this triangle you can say one is triangle PCA, C is right angle, and one is triangle BEP, it is also a right angle triangle. So one angle corresponding, they are congruent. What about this angle? You can check line AD and line P, they are parallel. And this is the transversal. AB is the transversal. So these two form a pair of corresponding angles, and as the lines are parallel, they are always congruent. So angle PAC is equal to angle BPE. So in these two triangles, two corresponding angles are equal. So by angle theorem, these two triangles are similar. And for the similar triangle, we can take the ratio of the corresponding sides. Okay? And we can compare them. So for these two triangles, which are triangles? One is triangle PCA and second is triangle BEP. These two triangles are similar. Okay? So what are the corresponding sides? AP upon PB is equal to, here I can say the corresponding side for AC, and here it is PD, P. P equal to CD because they are equal sides. So this ratio we get, AP upon PB is equal to AC upon CD. Now as we know, AP upon PB, it is 1 upon 2. AC means what? I should find out first of all coordinates for point C. As it is coming from P, the x coordinate for C is x. As it is on y x axis, the y will be 0. So it is at 0. For point D, it is 36, comma, as the point is lying on the x axis, its y is 0. Got it? So what is AC? AC is x minus 0, that is x. CD, 36 minus x. So now comparing both the sides, 36 minus x ones are 36 minus x is equal to 2 into x, 2x. 2x plus x, 3x is equal to 36. So x is equal to 36 upon 3, 12. So x is equal to 12, I got. The x coordinate for point P is 12. Similarly, now I can go for finding its y coordinate. Okay? So same thing I apply here. First of all, let us check which two triangles are becoming similar. For that, from point E, I draw perpendicular to y axis, and suppose this point is F. So what are the coordinates of F? As it is point on y axis, x is 0, and what is y? It is y. Now from point B, I draw a perpendicular, suppose it is point G. As it is on y axis, x is 0 and y is 15. Okay? So now, if I go for these two triangles, then again, V two triangles will be similar as we kept here, this and this. Here I can go for this and this sides. So again, I go for the formula AP upon PB. AP upon PB is equal to AF upon FG, 2 is to 1. AF upon FG. AP upon PB is 1 upon 2. AF, y minus 0, that is y. FG, 15 minus y. That is 15 minus y ones are 15 minus y is equal to 2 into y, 2y. Minus y changes the side, becomes plus y, so 2y plus y, 3y is equal to 15. So y is equal to 15 upon 3, it is 5. So what are the coordinates of point P? Point P, x, y is equal to 12, 5. So this is how we can find out the coordinates of the point on the line segment. We divide the line segment into some given ratio. Is it clear? So this is the technique I have told you. But now using the technique, we will develop a formula. And we will use that formula for every question. Okay? So be ready. Now we are going to derive the formula, which is known as section formula. Is it clear? So we take the graph first of all and we try to understand. These are x and y axis. This is line segment AB. Okay. Point A having the coordinates x1, y1. Point B having the coordinate x2, y2. And there is a point P on this line segment having the coordinate x and y. I want to find out what is x, what is y, and for that I am going to develop the formula. Okay, so same technique. From point A, suppose it is C, while from point B it is D, and from point B it is E. Okay, so in the previous one, suppose the ratio in which they divide is m is to n. Okay, m is to n is the ratio. Previous it was 1 is to 2, now I take it as m is to n. It is decided. Now if point P divide line segment AB from point A in the ratio m is to n, then what is x, what is y? I want to find out the formula. I want to develop the formula. Okay? So, AP upon PB is equal to, as we did in the previous example, CD upon B. CD upon B. AP upon PB is what? M is to N. Okay? Now, CD. What are the coordinates for C? It is x1, 0, B, x, 0, E, x2, 0. So what is CD? X minus x1 upon B, x2 minus x. Again, I take CD is x minus x1 and D is x2 minus x. Okay? So, m upon n, sorry, I take the cross multiplication, m x2 minus m x is equal to n x minus n x1. So I get together x and x1 terms. So is equal to n x plus m x. And here on the right left hand side, mx2 plus nx1. Okay? So mx2 plus nx1 is equal to, here x common, n plus m, right hand right, m plus n. Got it? So therefore, mx2 plus nx1 whole upon m plus n is equal to x. So this is the formula for coordinate of point Px. What is that?